हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम स्वप्निल विजय घोगरदरे, वर्किंग एट DY पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, अकुर्डी, पुणे। टुडे आई एम मेकिंग दिस वीडियो ऑन रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी सोर्सेस एंड कार्बन फुटप्रिंट कैलकुलेशंस। दिस इज माय थर्ड वीडियो फॉर द इंटरनेशनल FDP ऑन एनवायरमेंटल अवेयरनेस एंड सस्टेनेबिलिटी। सो इन दिस आई ऑलरेडी शेयर्ड माय प्रीवियस टू वीडियोज ऑन रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी won't run out, maintenance requirements and are lower, save money and has numerous health and environmental benefits. All energy sources have some impact on our environment. Advantages and limitations of renewable energy sources are presented. Impacts of solar power, biomass power, wind power, geothermal power and hydroelectric power are discussed, as well as their ecological, social and political impacts are also described. In second video, I prepared for ISO standards for energy helps us to move towards affordable and clean energy. It also gives concrete solutions and best practice for energy efficiency. It helps to organizations to reduce energy consumption and adopt renewable energy sources. ISO standards are continually reviewed and improved to achieve national and international objectives and commitments. ISO standards helps organizations reduce their energy consumption and adopt renewable energy technologies. ISO standards for energy helps us to move towards affordable and clean energy for all. So, outcomes of these videos are, this video are, identify how globalized processes impact socio-ecological systems. Able to recognize physical, chemical, and biological components of the Earth system. Implicit applications and importance, as well as can explain different types of renewable energy sources. Calculate carbon footprint and how it will help to reduce carbon emission of environment. Proper consumption of energy and use of other sources from environment. 6.1. How to select and purchase efficient home appliances and future scope for their study. Learn how to solve large-scale problems using a multitude of tools and approaches. Should able to understand requirements and need of renewable sources. Understand the basic sustainability concepts of ecosystems and services. So there are IEEE and ISO standards. So in that title, scope and purpose, IEEE 15262003 title, under this scope is testing performance of PV system, and purpose of this is it gives methods and procedure to determine PV system and conducting design verification. Then second one, ISO 17225 2014 for testing performance of biogas. This series is made for biomass, which may be used as fuel for heat and electrical generation. Then ISO TC 238 is standardization of terminology, quality assurance, test methods of raw and processed materials. Purpose, use as source for solid biofuels. ISO TC 301, standardization in the field of energy management and energy savings. And purpose of this is used as energy management and energy savings. ISO TC 207, standardization in the field of environment management system, and purpose is for environment. So next slide is carbon emission footprint calculations. So computation, in that carbon footprint is the total amount of greenhouse gases produced which directly and indirectly support human activities expressed in tons of carbon dioxide. It is nothing but summation of all CO2 and is calculated for the time period of 1 year. After burning 1 liter of petrol emitted, 2.3 kg of CO2 is produced. After burning of 1 liter of diesel, it emits 2.7 kg of CO2. If a car travels 100 km and consumes 5 liter of diesel, which adds 1 to 2.7 kg of CO2. Following activities add 1 kg of CO2 to your personal carbon footprint. Number 1, traveling of public transportation for 10 to 12 kilometers. operation of computer for 32 hours produce 2 plastic bottles and 5 plastic bags. Carbon emission is the carbon footprint. Carbon emission is the release of carbon into the atmosphere by human as well as nature. In natural sources includes decomposition, ocean release and respiration. Human sources comes from activities like deforestation, cement production, burning of fossil fuels like coal, oil and natural gas. Greenhouse gas emission are measured in carbon dioxide equivalent. Carbon footprint is an amount of greenhouse which are surrounded the earth released into atmosphere and measured as CO2 emitted per year. By burning of gas, oil, coal, a dark layer of greenhouse gas is generated which restrict to allow heat to escape and result in increase in temperature of an environment. So this is a calculation for carbon footprint. So if we see the public transport, in that if we travel by bus for 1,000 kilometer, then we considered here for 1,000, so total bus and rail footprint equals to 0.11 metric tons of CO2. So let's see what are the calculations. So in this, mileage is 1,000 kilometer, so chosen vehicle is average van or motorbike or car database. So motorbike, so in this, if you see, the limit is 2 entries. The total carbon footprint is 0.22 metric tons of CO2. So 0.02 metric tons, 100 kilometer in average car petrol, car small petrol car up to 1.4 liter, and 0.20 metric tons, 1000 kilometer in a USA, 2015 BMW, 328 semi-auto, 8 2WD diesel vehicle. So this is a chart for comparing various car running on different fuels, that is for 1000 kilometer per month. So petrol car, electric car and solar car. In this, if you see the rate for petrol car is 80 rupees per liter, for electric car 22 rupees per charge unit, and solar it's only 5 rupees per unit. Mileage for petrol car is 16 kilometer per liter. Then in electric we will get 80 kilometers per charge, and also in solar we get 80 kilometers per charge. The running cost per kilometer in rupees for petrol 5 rupees, then electric car 0.275, and for solar 0.0625 rupees. So amount spent per year in rupees for petrol, that is 60,000, for electric 3,300, and solar only 750 rupees. Savings which we'll get with all these types is maximum spent 60,000. So electric car 56,700, and solar car 59,250. So different energies and carbon footprint in gram CO2 per kWh. So for wind we are having 11, coal 980, natural gas 465, nuclear 12, solar 14.45, hydro 7, ocean 8, geothermal 11.3247, biomass 43. So this is taken from the research by NREL and BNL. So which are the different steps to reduce carbon footprint? So proper use of certified renewable energy sources, calculate the carbon footprint, minimize driving by walking, cycling, carpooling, using public transports, minimize purchase of new products, especially heavily packaged products, install solar panel for water heating and for electricity, encourage and support to reduce practice greenhouse in community, use of proper LED bulbs and all energy efficient appliances, proper management of water resources and their use, reuse and recycling, focus on buying energy efficient heating, cooling and water heating, office and industry equipments, keep regular equipment maintenance. So these are the various steps to reduce carbon footprint. So if you see the renewable energy sources, in that, first one is energy, wind energy. So the ISO standard for wind energy is ICS 27.180 for to standardize wind energy system, including generation of electrical energy purposes. This is clean, long life, reliable, pollution free, affordable and sustainable energy. It's a clean fuel source. Wind energy doesn't pollute the air like power plants that really rely on combustion of fossil fuels such as coal or natural gas. Wind turbines don't produce atmospheric emissions that cause acid rain or greenhouse gases. Wind energy is a domestic source of energy. It's sustainable for as long as the sun shines and the wind blows. The energy produced can be sent power across the grid. Wind power is cost effective. It is one of the lowest price renewable energy technologies available today. Then second one we are having, that is a solar energy. The production of solar energy does not generate noise pollution. Very important. Solar power is pollution free and cause no greenhouse gases to be emitted after installation. Reduce dependence on foreign oil and fossil fuels. This system doesn't require any outside supply for its working, so its maintenance and production cost is almost zero. Transportation losses are less as the distance between production and supply point is less. Easy to install, almost to everywhere. Fulfill their social responsibility to reduce carbon emissions. Also fulfill social responsibilities to reduce carbon emissions, reduce electricity bill and save money. Enhance the resiliency and reliability of the electricity supply. So the conclusion of this video is, present non-renewable sources in energy consumption cannot sustain much longer, which are responsible for global warming, environment imbalance and ozone layer depletion. To save the environment, we should stop the exploitation of natural resources by planting useful trees, recycling, reuse, reduce in pollutions, and to create awareness about the environment. Therefore, under such circumstances, it's quite necessary switch to natural source of power and energy. Renewable energy sources are less expensive and less improved in efficiency. Renewable energy technologies could reduce CO2 emissions by replacing fossil fuels in the power generation industry and the transportation sector. Power generation using renewable energy sources should be increased in order to decrease the unit cost of generation. Energy consumption depends on several factors including economic progress, population, energy prices, weather and technology. So this is my video. Please do like and share my video. Thank you. Thank you all.